I want to talk about patriotism, because when I look at America, I see a country that commits barbaric child sex change surgeries, drag shows with men in BDSM gear twerking in front of children, a country which has destabilized the Middle East and flooded Europe with refugees, and a country that promotes the most vile, disgusting porn industry on the planet.
Yep.
I want, and furthermore, I see a right that is obsessed with libertarianism, but has no concern with duty, honor, and implementing actual legislation against these things. So I want to know, how can you be a patriot for America, given how America is basically modern-day Sodom and Gomorrah?
Because it's fitting to be patriotic, because love of one's country is a natural extension of the love of one's own family. And people have plenty of awful moms and dads, but nevertheless, we are to honor our mother and father, and we are to respect the civil authority. And you've recited a litany of awful practices that the United States is engaged in. And I could give you a lot more, by the way. You barely scratched the surface. However, it is your country, and the other countries around the world are not looking particularly hot either. You know, even the ones that seem to be doing better on a couple of those categories, very often they're actually not quite so hot on those either. And taken as a whole, every country is going to have its own problems. And so, to be a patriot, especially to be a conservative patriot, is to try to conserve the good, the true, and the beautiful, to pull out the very best of the tradition. And you scolded the libertarians, as I do frequently. You know, I am not a libertarian myself, but libertarians can be somewhat helpful in forming a coalition. I mean, the simple fact is there just aren't that many trads in the United States, and so, you know, we need all of the help that we can get. But furthermore, you know, to just throw one's hands up and say, well, you know, my country's gone to pot, and so I have nothing good to say about it, is that not in itself an extraordinarily individualistic, even potentially libertarian view to hold? I sort of think it is, this political quietism that sometimes crops up in circles with people who are disillusioned with the way the country is run. But I don't think that that's appropriate at all. I think we are called to public life. I think that especially in a nation that is at least notionally self-governing, we have a real obligation to do that. And I think we have a real prospect of doing that as well. You mentioned the problems on the right. It's true. The right for a long time was extraordinarily weak, gelded, if you will. I mean, it was really, really weakened. But that has changed over the last 6-7 years. I'm speaking at a nonprofit institution with a nonprofit organization, so I'm not supposed to name any political candidates. But it is simply a fact that the most prominent people on the right in the last 6-7 years have not really been pushing that particular view. They've been much more comfortable wielding political power, as they should be, because we ought to wield political power for the good. I mean, that's why people elect us on the happy occasions that they do elect us. And so I do not think that all hope is lost, and I think despair is a sin, and I think hope is not only a virtue but a fact, and I think you ought to love your country.